Making a human head out of numbers in After Effects has become one of my long-standing obsessions. If you're curious to see where it all began, just Google Digitman Eran Stern, and you'll find a much younger version of me with hair and a painfully slow pace, showing you how to do it with a mix of techniques, some even using third-party effects. But today, we're going to take a more elegant route using only built-in tools. Now, this is the first part of a trilogy of easy tutorials about text effects. I say easy, but let's see if you still think so once you try it yourself. Stick around until the end for a quick preview of what's coming up next, and let me know in the comments below what is your favorite text effect. Alright, let's stop wasting time and dive into our digit person. Alright, first step, let's create the numbers grid. I'll start with a new composition. I'm using the first HD preset, so 10 seconds long, and I'll name it Digits. Now, I'll create a new solid and apply the grid effect. Then I'll change the anchor to -1 for both X and Y, so the grid sits just one pixel outside of the comb. Then I'll set the size to from width and height sliders. Then adjust both of them to 22 with a border set to 1 pixel. Now this layer is just a visual guide to help position the digits inside each square, so it shouldn't render. To make sure it doesn't, I'll turn it into a guide layer. Now let's zoom into the upper corner of the grid, and then I'll create a new text layer and type the digit 0. I'm using Courier New, which is a monospaced font, but feel free to pick any other font you like. Since 22 is our magic number from the grid, I'll set the text size to 22 pixels as well and position it in the center of the first cell. Now I'll apply my text repeater preset, which is free, and you can grab it from the link down below. And to figure out how many characters we need, I'll divide the comp width by the text size. So 1920 divided by 22 gives us about 87. So I'll round it up. And for the lines, I'll do the same thing. This time I'll divide 1080 by 22, which is a bit over 49, so I'll round it up as well. Next, in the properties panel, I'll change the leading to 22 and tweak the tracking until each letter sits nicely in the center of each one of those cells. Now, to make those digits move randomly, I'll add the character offset animator and set it to the full Unicode. And then change the character offset to 8. You can go with any value. I think that 8 is going to give us a nice result. Then I'll delete the range selector and add a wiggly selector instead. I'll open it up and set the wiggles per second to 1 for a slower, more cinematic animation. And then I'll go ahead and preview this comp. And you should see a lovely grid of random digits flickering away like there's no tomorrow and Neo is not in the matrix. And now for the fun part. I'll create another new composition, about 8 seconds long, and name it Human Algorithm. Next, I'll drag in a video. In my case, it's a woman with David Bowie style eyes. So I called her Lady Stardust, of course. So you can use any video you like, but close-up portraits works best for this technique. Using the pen tool, I'll draw a rough mask around the head of the lady here. And this is basically the area that I want to reference. Then I'll turn off the visibility of this layer. And now I'll bring down the digits comp and apply the card dance effect to it. Now the card dance animates layers using gradient data. And the best part of it that it actually supports After Effects 3D space, letting us use the luma information from another layer to drive the card spread and the animation. Let's see how to set it up. So I'm going to start by setting the rows to 49 and then the columns to 87, just like before. Then I'll choose the Lady Stardust layer as gradient layer 1 and make sure to include masks. Next, I'll trill open the Z position and set the source to intensity 1. And now, the luma value that this video has is driving the depth location of each one of those digits. We can adjust the multiplier to spread those digits in 3D space until it looks good. Which is pretty cool, right? But you'll notice that it's still treating the entire image, ignoring the mask boundary that we set. So to fix that, I'll open X and Y scale here, and I'll set both of them to use intensity 1 as well. And now it will respect the mask. Next, let's animate a few things to make it more dynamic. I'll start with the Z position multiplier. So I'll go to the start and set it to 6. And then after 5 seconds, I'll return it back to 1. Then I'll open the camera position. By the way, you can use a comp camera, but for this demo, we'll stick with the built-in one. So here at 5 seconds, I'll set keyframes for X rotation and Y rotation as well as Z position. And then I'll pull back the camera so the face will fill the frame nicely. Then I'll go back to the start and change the X rotation to 25 degrees, the Y rotation to 30 degrees, and the Z position to 0.5. Feel free to change those values, but in this case you can see it brings the camera closer to us and also orbit it. Then I'm going to select the last keyframes and press F9 to easy ease them. And let's preview to see how this works. And I think this looks amazing. So this is basically the core effect, but let's make it even better and prettier by adding a fill effect with a bright cyan color. And then let's also add a glow effect on top of it and increase the glow radius to around 60. Amazing. Looks so much better. Now, to give it a bit more context, I'm going to copy a text that I've already created ahead of time. And this one is using the same character offset animator just for consistency. So we'll have some title for this fictional program. And I'm also going to create an adjustment layer and add to it the CC force motion blur just to smooth out the first few seconds so you can trim it when the text is visible. And this will also help to hide the pixelated digits when we are zooming in close. Now I'll add some sound effects that I've prepared ahead of time, and here's what we get. What do you think? Let me know in the comments below and join me next time when I'll show you how to use custom glyphs in After Effects to turn any boring text into a true typography artwork, even when the subject is one of the biggest disasters in aviation history. Also, don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon just to make sure you won't miss this, as well as the next tutorials, which I'm cooking right here in my secret After Effects oven.